Today I will try to fix a Makita drill, which I doubt very much I would be able to. The reason is when these drills go bad, well, I wouldn't really say bad, but it's working, but if you look here, you'll see flames and you could smell something is not right. And also that backlash. Usually when this happens, it's the motor. This is a brush, or should I say it has brushes. It's not brushless, and I believe the brushes are going. Now with these drills, the motor is so small that it's better to buy a motor and put in it than trying to repair this motor. With all that said, if you're new to this channel, please subscribe, like, comment, and click on the bell icon to be notified of further videos. Let me start dismantling. Take out the battery. It has 9 screws, 5 at the top and 4 at the bottom. To get the screws out, I'll be using this and also a screwdriver. Now the screws are out. All you have to do now is lift gently or put something right here and try to pry it open. This is what it looks like. And this is the motor. This is the switch, the battery holder, and the gearbox. And to remove the motor, you simply lift. To remove this, you would either push it down. It has a spring here and there. If you push it up and you notice it's stiff, you will then push it down and just lift the back gently. If you see, notice the 2 springs. That is the speed selector. It's 2 speeds and it's attached to this, moving it up and down. Now to get the gearbox out, you simply turn gently and pull. This is what it looks like. Now if you notice these splines came out, Now since I open that, I will not be changing the motor, but I will tell the client to get another motor. But usually when you enter, you would have to clean and so forth. I will just pack it with some grease. This is, if you have a drill that gives problem, you would know exactly what to do.
I have some gloves. We have to make sure that it enters. Then I'll put some lubricant here. Put this plate back. And try to fiddle the oil in. Give it a little knack to make sure you have it the right way. gears are not sitting right. It have some grooves here. You have to get them put in. This is it. There's nothing holding it in, so all you have to do now is put it in. Make sure the spring goes.
Okay, Shana. Place your hand on it so it won't come out. Turn it gently. once you get it in, you put your cover back. Make sure everything is okay. This is it. You put your rest of your screws in. I'll tell the client he need a motor. If you find this video was informative, please like, comment, subscribe, and click on the bell icon to be notified of further videos. Everything I use in this video, I'll have it in, I'll have a link in the description below. Until the next one, goodbye. See you.